up, guys? Welcome to the vlog. Currently sitting outside right now. It's Saturday morning, May 30th, I think. About to do my journal. Upload yesterday's vlog, all the footage to my computer. I don't know what we're going to do today. I got a pretty cool morning starting off. We're going to do a podcast. I haven't did a podcast in a while. It's been over a year since I did my last podcast where I was actually on it. So I'll be on a podcast today, and that'll be fun. So let's jump into that. About to hop into the podcast, and you guys already know what I need to waken up. Let's see. Oh, nice old 3D. Got the orange one today. Should actually save it for tomorrow so I can do like a mimosa. So yeah, so this podcast, pretty much just had this guy, his name is Ali. He reached out to me via Instagram. I was just like, hey, I like the shit you post. We're in a few different groups together. Honestly, it kind of felt kind of automated and kind of like, you know, copy and paste message. But further to fact, he does done a lot of podcasts with other people. And I always enjoy doing them now, even with like smaller channels and stuff, because eventually one day I want to be on a few big ones. And I know like I'm just gonna kind of practice with these smaller channels. So we'll see how it goes, and update you guys after. So it looks like the guy I was supposed to be doing a podcast with today just totally bailed. I guess that's something that I should be worried about when I'm taking on these smaller podcast shows of you know, people flaking like that. So right now what I'm doing is I use that extra time that was supposed to be in the podcast I scheduled out for to finish up today's vlog. Right now what I'm doing is I'm going through my ads and stuff and just checking out some of the results. Saturday mornings is usually slow, like an extra hour, because people like to sleep a little later on Saturday, so usually it doesn't start picking up to like 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. Right now it's 10:55 a.m. So one of our stores right now is converting at a 4x return, already up $2,500 for today, which is absolutely insane. 4x return at $574. Another one of our stores is currently converting right now at 3x return. We spent $719 so far today. We're up $2,600. One store, not doing too hot. $139 spent, $159 back. Yeah. Good start to the morning. Nothing really major that needs my attention. So now we're gonna fix some breakfast because I am starving. Ooh, there we go. 2 packets of oatmeal, 8 ounces of egg whites, and I got some pineapple over there. I'm about to sit down and watch a little bit of YouTube. So about to leave right now, head to the gym. I just launched an ad campaign with 100 ad sets in it and doing some crazy testing with some micro bidding and stuff, and I'll probably make a video on it in a few days just to let you guys know of how that turned out. But I cannot wait to show you guys the results once that kicks up, because there's been a lot of people using it in a group I'm currently in right now, and they've been crushing it with results. So I'm gonna show you guys that in a few days. All right, so here's the fit. And guess what? I don't think I told you guys yet today, but we got the Vans on. So you know what that means? Either squats or deadlifts. And we did squats Wednesday. So guess what? We're doing some deadlifts today. Super hyped up because I haven't did deadlifts in a very long time. I will be doing sumo deadlifts too. I'm not doing traditional because traditional don't matter how perfect my form is. It just happens. I ended up fucking my back up a little later down the road, but sumo has never failed me once. So we're doing some sumo deadlifts today, some abs, and some calves. Saturdays is kind of like my just touch-up day, and that's the only muscles I did not work this week. So before that, we're going to get some nice carbohydrates to fuel this workout. And what is the best way for some fast-acting carbs? They need a Rice Krispie treat. So let's go pick up one, and I'll see you guys in the gym after. Also, too, I'm dropping off Kennedy's leftovers from last night, which is a big, juicy burger to her at work. And honestly, oh, all I want to do is eat it. yo, the goods have been secured. Here's what I wanted. This whole bar right here is 48 grams of carbs and 6 grams of fat. So perfect, just some pre-workout carbs and stuff. I'll probably get Chipotle after, do a protein shake a little later on, and have some food to finish off my last meal already pre-cooked at home. So I won't have to cook tonight. And also this is like $2, Chipotle would be like $10, so we'll be good to go. Just got to the gym, guys. Super hyped up for today because I actually got a proper tripod for this workout, so I can give you way better angles during it. So let's get started. This was the tripod I was talking about. See how it was. Jump into this workout now. Jumping, starting off this workout with some deadlifts. First time in a while I've done any deadlifts, so found me a little spot. It's the first time I've ever used the deadlift platform over here, so it'd be pretty cool. Just got 245 for 5. Now go ahead and try doing 265 for 5. 245 felt good. Just my grip is loosening up towards the end. I haven't put over 200 pounds in my hand in a long time, so try to change it up. Go for 265 now. Don't close your eyes. So hit it. Actually made two mistakes this week between counting that as 265 is actually 255. And then on my squat this week, I thought I did 245, actually 235. And I'm gonna work back down to 10 reps of a weight that's still pretty heavy, then 15 reps to burn everything out. Also, check out this whole setup right here. Hopefully, got a better shot. Not gonna lie right now, guys, I am absolutely drained right now. So finish up this exercise and then Stairmaster for 20 minutes, and then we're gonna go to Chipotle. I cannot wait for that because I'm absolutely starving right now. Update, that was easily the hardest cardio session I've done yet. Still 20 minutes. I've been doing 20 minutes every day this week at level 10 on the Stairmaster, which is, I've always done 10 on the Stairmaster since, you know, my first cut 3 years ago. I've always did 10, and I just bump up the timing and everything like that. All right, I am officially miserable right now. I am absolutely starving in traffic right now, and all I smell is good Mexican from Chewy's right there, burgers from Five Guys, and all this other really freaking good food that all I want to do is dive into, and I'm absolutely starving right now. Oh, this is gonna be rough these next 30 days. I want to do the pinto. I want to do half and half with the chicken and the, it's that special type of steak meat. Half and half with the chicken and it's that other type of steak meat, the, yeah. Oh, okay.
Okay, do that one.
Do you want a half scoop of each or you want double
meat? Double
meat. I just dumped everything into here. I got a bowl. Stay away from a tortilla because it's more carbs, obviously. But it's one serving of chicken, one serving of beef, two servings of rice, and some lettuce and pinto beans. And I'm gonna show you guys really quick what it comes out to. Let's see. The whole thing comes out to 855 calories, 91 grams of carbs, 22 grams of fat, and 75 grams of protein. And then after this, I'm gonna have two scoops of protein and almond milk, but I'm gonna have this about 2 hours later when we're leaving to go to a little dinner thing. And I still have 12 grams of fat, 72 grams of carbs, and 38 grams of protein for the night. We plan on eating boiled seafood tonight, so I'm gonna try to eat just the meat, stay away from the sauces and stuff, and then probably have like a drink or something, and I'll fill up my carbs and my protein. So that's kind of what my whole diet is looking like today. But I'm gonna sit down now and relax because I am absolutely dead. Enjoy this meal. Just woke up, so I didn't even brush my teeth or anything in my face. So just warn you now. It's 11 o'clock in the morning. I had to crack open a 3D real quick. Honestly, I slept like shit last night. I got way too consumed with all the rioting and all that shit on Twitter. Way too consumed before bed, so my mind was just racing for a while. I could really never get to sleep good, so, but I do have a lot going on today. I'm gonna give you guys a little diet update real quick. So, we're currently now, this is what we're looking like. Definitely leaning out a little bit. And let's do a little weigh-in. Watch over there. 160. This whole week we've been about 161, 160.8, 161, and 160.2. So we've been averaging 160 since I kind of like started back up with that. But I can tell y'all right now, the way I'm feeling and stuff, I'm starting to feel like I'm getting into a diet, like I'm starting to get the cravings. I'm starting to feel the feeling of just being leaner. I'm starting to get the feeling of just consistently being hungry, not being full after each meal. And I'm still eating pretty good calories. I need to get this bathroom cleaned up, I need to get the house cleaned up, and after that, I need to go to the store, and then be cooking later. For family be coming over and stuff. So kind of get the house situated before they get here. I can see it, but I would say that's a pretty damn clean floor.
Just finished up mopping, vacuuming, all that good stuff. Now we're gonna go ahead and I need to finish up folding some clothes. And then finally cook breakfast. It's 12:11 and I'm about to cook breakfast. Damn.
You guys, we got for meal one. I got two packets of oatmeal. 8 ounces of egg whites with a little bit of hot sauce on it, some salt and pepper, and some cranberry juice. I normally do like a side of fruit with my breakfast in the morning, but because I didn't have any, I'm using cranberry juice to kind of fill up the carbs.
Little update, it has been a while now. This is the last I saw your camera. I think y'all saw like, yeah, cooking breakfast and stuff.
Kennedy's over. I've been kind of chilling and stuff. We just got back from the store. There's a bunch of other stuff we were trying to put away. But got everything we need.
A few things for me for like during the week to eat. And also everything we need for the jambalaya that's gonna be cooking tonight. Kind of have like a high carb day. So not like a full cheat meal or cheat day, just a high carb day. Still watching our fats and our protein. So I got a bunch of things just high in carb, sugar. And then tonight, good jambalaya.
All right guys, quick update. I just want y'all to see that sausage. Look at that. Y'all could smell this right now. So basically what we do is we cook the pork first, then we cook down the chicken, then we cook down the sausage, take all that out, cook down the vegetables, and throw everything back together with the rice. And we'll be good to go.
Got the Michelob as well. And got a full thing,
all of our vegetables and stuff. Let's be going in there. All right, so I already fixed my food and ate it all, but this is like a bowl of sitting home with my parents. And here's the final look. It came out absolutely amazing, and highly recommend it. Shout out to the Cajun Ninja on YouTube for the recipe. That's his meaty jambalaya. So now I'm gonna indulge in something nice and sweet and full of carbohydrates.
Hey guys, what's going on? It's actually a few days later now. It's currently Wednesday. It was this weekend is when I filmed this vlog, but I completely forgot to film an outro. So here is the outro for this video. I ended up kind of underestimating how fatty the jambalaya was. So instead of just like a refeed day, how I wanted to be with low fats, low carbs, just extreme low fats, low protein, extremely high on carbs. The fats were pretty damn high, but hey, that's a mistake I will learn from for the future next time I do a refeed day / cheat day. But just want to thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button. If you're new to the channel, I make Facebook ad videos, business videos, and vlogs. So make sure you hit that subscribe button. I'll see you guys later. Peace.